Okay, now picture this. You hop into your 11 a.m. Zoom class and you're out here looking like a rag with your laptop webcam. Then you see John over there with his super crisp webcam and you wonder, how is he doing that? Well, let me explain in this video. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Dax Brule here, back with another one. And today we're going to be talking about how to use your mirrorless Canon camera or your DSLR Canon camera as a webcam for your Zoom calls, your Skype calls, any sort of call that requires a sort of webcam and you to be present there. So you can look a lot more professional and a lot more beautiful on the cam. This is going to be a simple guide. I'm just going to walk you guys through. Shouldn't be too long. So let's hop into the computer and let's do it. Okay, so we're here in the computer. I deleted the app because I want to show you guys from the start how the heck to do it. So the first thing you got to do is simply search up Canon EOS R downloads or whatever your camera is. This is how you're going to be able to tell if your camera can actually support this. You're just going to want to go to the support page for the specific camera model you have, not the lens, the camera. Drivers and downloads, simple button right there. It's going to bring you down to software. Make sure you have the right operating system. Most of you should be on Windows 10. You can scroll down. You can see the date that they were produced. So you just want to look for EOS R Webcam Utility 1.0. There's probably going to be more down here, but these are older versions, so obviously you want the newer version. So it's simple. Select, put in your information. Bang, once you click that, you just click the download button, and then there it should download. Just ask you a couple questions to secure who you are. So bang, simple, downloaded. EOS R Webcam Utility, you guys know how this works. It's a zip file, so you're just gonna come in here, just collect all that, and I just like to copy it to the outside and then delete the zip file. Now to download this file, all you're gonna wanna click on is the setup file that was given to you, and then you're gonna put in all the information. So I'm just gonna go through this really quick. It should be simple for you guys to do it as well. And bang, there you go. So we're gonna check if it's actually installed. We're gonna come down to the Canon apps, and EOS R Webcam Utility is there. That's so you can check if it's actually on your computer. Okay, now we switched over to the phone cam because I need the camera itself to show you guys that this actually works. You can't be running a recording and also the EOS R utility beta at the same time, but we're going to show you guys exactly how this works. One thing to note that I completely forgot to mention is that you actually need to connect the camera itself. Right here, I have my EOS R connected via USB-C and then plugged into the computer, the laptop itself, or the desktop itself, whichever device you are using. So we're just going to open up a simple app like Zoom, for example, where we can check if our settings are actually working for all of our audio devices, all our video devices. So you just want to click here on the settings button. Super easy. We're going to be coming down to the video setting. This is where we can check. And as you can see, camera, EOS R utility beta, it should be preset. If you have another webcam, you're going to have two options here. So you can choose which webcam you actually want to use. But there you go. EOS R utility beta is set. You can choose aspect ratio, enable HD if you want it to be HD. And then there you go on the screen. You can actually see it's turning around. One thing to note, if you have a log profile selected, which I do on this camera, it's going to display log. So what it's really doing is just showing you what's in the viewfinder, repeating it onto the thing. So if you want it to look clean and crisp, you're going to have to switch it to a non-log profile, to a Rec 709. Just mount this up on a tripod, put it towards you, and then that can be your, like this could be my angle for my class. Last thing to note, if you do have EOS R utility, the app that lets you record from the computer, it lets you download images from the computer when your camera's plugged in, you have to make sure that's not running or else this won't work and it'll just display EOS R utility beta instead of your actual camera. So how you do that is you're gonna search up Task Manager on the Windows, and then you're gonna see all the apps. Usually it's in background processes. I already disabled it, but if you see something called EOS R utility, it's gonna look exactly like this right here on the computer, EOS R utility. Then you're just gonna wanna disable that because that will be stopping the app from working itself. So that's pretty much how you do it. You make sure you have a good microphone, you make sure you have your camera, and then you can look crispy clean on your Zoom calls. So yeah, that's the video. Question of the day for you guys, how many Zoom classes do you have a week? Me, I'm going part-time at university, so I have 3 a week. Zoom is pretty much taking over all of educational institutions right now, so you really have to be ready to hop on a Zoom conference, and I'm sure it's going to be very useful for our future as well. So hope you guys enjoyed that video. Again, my name is Dax Brule. Like, comment, subscribe if you enjoyed. I got videos coming out every single week, and without further ado, creators, keep creating. Peace.